All right, everybody. This is a week one recap of my fantasy football. I did end up winning my game. We'll go back here. Slow internet. I'm sure someone's had a birthday by now. All right, here we go. Rock River Cowboys. I won 164-24 to 119-48. Luckily, he had some really good guys on his bench. But I had pretty good. This is the NFL Network app. And I really like how they show the ranking of each player for that individual week. Like Sammy Watkins. He was the number one wide receiver and fantasy points-wise for that week. So that's what I like. Drew Brees had a good game, 12th overall quarterback for the week. He had one interception, which was very uncharacteristic of him in the red zone. But he came back through for 300-plus yards, really helped me out. Joe Mixon here, he would have done good, but he ended up getting a high ankle sprain, which pulled him out of the game, really. So that always hurts, really hurts your team when stuff like that happens. And I had it happen twice, two of my guys. I'll get the other guy here in a little bit. But he should be available for week two. That's what they're saying. They're going to monitor him. If he is available for week two, I'll still stick with him. I like Joe Mixon. Sammy Watkins, unbelievable. He will not have another week like this for the rest of the season. That was just unbelievable. I told you once before, I like teams that throw the ball a lot, and Chiefs throw the ball a lot. So do the Saints. Really happy I got him. Next guy, Derrick Henry. He was the third overall running back for this week. Did a great job. He was having an okay game until he caught a 75-yard pass and took it to the house. And that really helped. Did a good job. James Conner he's a better running back than what he produced. 29th overall for the week. But New England just owned the entire Pittsburgh Steelers. It was unbelievable. Pittsburgh couldn't get anything going on offensively. But James Conner, I had him last year. He did great for me last year. He'll pick it back up and he'll do a lot better. Next, the rookie, Josh Jacobs for Oakland. I picked him. I think he was either my third or fourth running back I grabbed. I'm an Oklahoma guy. He's from Oklahoma. He played for Alabama against Oklahoma. I can't remember who it was he laid out in the championship game. But the guy's just a tough, young, physical running back. And Oakland's actually got a pretty good, decent line, so I took him. And as of right now, pretty glad I took him. He ended up being the seventh overall running back for the week at 24.3 points. So pretty happy about that. Next, here's my other injury guy, Albert Wilson. He ended up hurting his calf. I pulled his calf cramps, whatever, I don't know. So he had to leave the game early. So him and Joe Mixon did not do me any favors. But I don't think there's a lot of upside for Wilson. You got a lot of players on the team asking to be traded to get out of there. It's just a real catastrophe going on with the Miami Dolphins. Their offense is terrible. So I don't know if I'm going to play him again. Actually, as I was saying, I just thought I'm actually trying to trade him and grab Andrews from Baltimore, the tight end. Mark Andrews from Oklahoma, who had a great game. Him, Marquise Brown, Lamar Jackson, great game. Their offense is going to be a lot better than Miami Dolphins, so better chance to get more points. Greg Zuerlein, number three overall kicker for the week. I had some really good players this week. I hope that continues. 17 points. I mean, when your kicker can get you 17 points, that is a great great job. So I'm pretty happy about that. And he missed a field goal. So he was 4 out of 5. Not too happy about this one right here. Browns defense. Man, they just couldn't get it going. They had 4 sacks, but Tennessee, of all teams, just embarrassed them. Actually, the Browns embarrassed themselves with them, how many penalties they have. Really hurt them. So hopefully they can clean that up. Because I only chose one defense, one kicker, one defense. That's me. My bench didn't do too bad. Kirk Cousins, 14.32. Like I said, he will always be the backup. The only reason, I think his name's Armstead. I only picked him up because Leonard Fournette, last couple of years, has always been injury prone. Something, he'll probably have an ingrown toenail this season and had to miss like 6 games. So he's the only reason I picked him. Tariq Cohen, 12 points, 12.9 points. Actually did pretty good. Not bad. Most of those points came in the passing game. Sam Yeltsin for Pittsburgh, once again. My guy, Connors, goes down. I have Sam Yeltsin, which I had him last year when Connors went down and did a pretty good job. Everybody in my draft, this was a hand write-in because we didn't draft any who he was. Devin Singletary. No one knew who he was. They're like, who is he? Frank Gore should just take a seat. If he's honest with himself, he should just take a seat to Devin Singletary and let this young kid run. 14.8 points. He did a good job. He's not even, I don't think he's the number one running back. But I'm excited for him. I think he could be surpassed Frank Gore if he continues to keep doing good. He got 70 yards on 4 carries. If he continues doing good, he'll end up being a starter. And that's what I'm hoping for. This is just Randall Cobb is a flex position, but 16.9 points. Not bad. If Dallas's offense can keep going the way they're doing, I could see Randall Cobb having a very good year. Very good year. And being a very good flex option for me. I told you I like teams that pass a lot, so I got Ted Ginn Jr. He did a great job, 19.1 points. So I'm pretty happy. Pretty happy with my team, with the players I got. My starters did good. Most of them overachieved. Connor had a hard time against the defense, or against the defense of the New England Patriots. But I'm happy. I'm really happy with Breeze, Watkins, Henry, especially Josh Jacobs. Hopefully, Mixon get that foot healed and get on track. So that's it. And I said Wilson probably won't ever start for me again. I will probably, if Singletary, Tariq Cohen or Singletary, I'll put there. I don't know. It just depends on the matchup. But anyways, that's my week one recap. I won 164 to 119. Pretty happy about that. And move on to next week to try to go 2-0. Have a good one.